Welcome to today's coffee break. This is about filtering. We have a handy dandy guide on our ArcherPoint website that you can refer to if you like afterwards. But today what I want to do is cover some of the filters that I commonly use throughout the day, and I hope you do too. There's no reason for you to be reading through tons and tons of records when you could use filters to filter down the information that you're seeing. So the first thing I'd like to show you are the customers. Let's go ahead and look at those. All right, so here I have my customer list, and let's pretend for a minute that I want to look for a specific customer. I don't want to read through all these. Let's say I don't know their customer number, but I know their name or part of their name. So I can use filters to look for portions of their name. So what I want to do is go over here and choose name, because that's the information that I'm looking for. And then I'm just going to put in here star, A-N star. And what that does is it looks for any customer name that contains the letters A-N anywhere within the name. So we put a wild card at the end, a wild card at the beginning, and it looks for anything that contains that. So you see now my list is limited to any of the customers that contain the letters A-N. So let's say that I want to look for any that just end with the letters A-N. What I do is I only put an asterisk at the beginning. So we have star A-N, and I press enter, and now I only see customers whose name end with A-N. We can do the converse as well. We could search for anybody that begins with A-N, and now I see my customer that begins with the letters A-N. You can add something that ignores the case. In this instance, I knew that it was going to be case sensitive, so I typed a capital A. But what we can do is we can add an at sign. And what it will do is it ignores the case. So I don't need to know whether it's upper or lower case. And again, I can just include that. And it will include names that begin with a capital A. It will include anything that contains a small a, so it just completely ignores the case. You can also do it for things that end with the A-N. All right. So again, before, when I didn't put the at sign, I had to type a capital A. And in this case, I put the at sign and it didn't matter. So depending on what you're looking for, if you're not finding it right away because it's case sensitive, then you might want to throw that at the beginning. Some people just put their names in all caps and it doesn't matter, but that's a useful tip for when you're looking for information that might be case sensitive. So let's go ahead and look at our full customer list. And let's say that I do know numbers and I want to filter on the numbers. So I'm just going to change this to number. And I can type in the customer's number, or I can type in a range of numbers. So if I type in the customer number, it takes me to that customer. If I say I want to see my customers 10,000 through 30,000, I can type in that range as well. You can also add a pipe. And basically what we're saying here is we want to see customers 10,000 through 30,000 and the customer 50,000, right? And you'll see that my list changes accordingly. So that's handy. You can be looking for dollar amounts that way. You can look at any kind of number in the system using those symbols. You can also look for names. It doesn't need to be numbers. So let's say that I want to look at a location, and I want to look at my blue location and my yellow location. Okay, I could say this and that. Let's say that I want to look at customers with a balance greater than $1,000. I'm just going to pop this open so that I see additional fields available for filtering. And I'm going to go to all and choose balance. So if I want to see customers with a balance that's greater than $1,000, just press enter and I see everybody that's greater than $1,000. Let's say I want to see greater than $10,000. We can keep limiting the list here, 100,000, all right? So now we know who to make our phone calls to. I can also see who's got a credit on account. So I could see people with balances less than, let's say, a dollar. There we go. If I put a dollar in, I would see everybody that's also got a zero balance. So I like to put minus $1, and I see everybody that's got a credit balance on account. And over here in the balance field, you can see their credit balance. Likewise, when I did the greater than, you can see their balance over here. As I move through the fields, you'll see it changing. All right, so I don't see the balance field on this screen, but I'm still able to filter on it. It's still valid data that can be filtered on. All right, let's pop over to the sales orders and play with some date filters. Okay, so let's say that I want to see sales orders that were entered in the first period. I'm just going to change my filter criteria over here to document date. And I'm going to put in P1. So this is the first period that's in my system. I'm a year ahead. So this is everything that was entered in period one. Then we can change that to be period two. Right? You could also do period one through period three and see the first quarter. Right? So you don't need to type in the entire date. Let's say the current month is September. If I just put in 2-2, it knows I mean September 22nd of the current year of the system. If I want to see a previous month, I can just put the previous month and the day. I don't need to put the year. And when I press enter, it looks for that specific day. If I want to see things for today, I put in a T, enter, and it puts in today's date from my system. I don't have anything in there for today, but that's how it works. So the date filters, you're very rarely entering a complete date. This is being filtered, but also when you are entering dates in the system, you can use the same thing. If you want to put in the date for Monday, you can put in MO, and it'll put in Monday's date, TU, Tuesday's date, and so on. That concludes our lesson on using filters in Navision.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.